Yep. It ought to be only shooting 350 yards.
400 yards. But I think he's dead.
Yeah, he is.
I can still see him there.
Walt says 400. Might be a little bit further than that, actually.
Same gun, 25-06, same bullet, 115 grain barber BLD. Record for groundhog with a high fire rifle. They just shot one of this, so you'll see it. It'll be better 400 yards. And I just wanted to show up the cartridge a little bit and show you that it is a groundhog gun from you know where. Let's see, I gotta try to top what he did here. I doubt I'm gonna do it tonight, but he brought me up here and it's like gale force winds, and I'm standing by to see if a chance of hitting anything. There's a method to the madness there too. But,
yeah. Yeah, there's one Walt got. Bunch of shooting, pretty windy. We were shooting from up here off the pad. Just below that building there. Got permission to be there. Figuring somewhere right around 400 yards, and it's pretty small. I'd say this born this spring, so it's a pretty small target for that range. Yeah, I got that one. I'm figuring that one to be right around 500 yards. The first two shots I shot were 600 yard shots. Watched the first shot dialed in my second one, almost got that one. Have about a 10-15 mile an hour wind. And right there's the second longest one I've ever killed right there. I killed one a couple nights ago at about 640 yards, and my dad was with me. I didn't get it on film, so I'm trying to redo it over again. And that first one I was shooting at, those two shots, it's just 40 yards this way from where I killed that one the other night. But rangefinders make a heck of a difference. I got 120 grain ballistic tips in my 7mm Remington Magnum, got about 3450, and I got about 7 shells left, so hopefully there's some more banging to do here. Stick around. Hit him, but he got into the jing weeds, so figuring 575 somewhere near. I don't think it's quite 600. I only have a minute left, so I'm gonna see if I can get over here and maybe get that one out of the weeds and count them. Alright, right back there is where I'm shooting from. It was right on that pad where you see that cement wall. Right here is where impact was, where I hit him, and then
He went up into the jingweeds and I found him about 5 yards laying up in there. Figuring some 575, maybe 600 right in there somewhere. One down. Let's go see if I got this other one. Well, I know I got the other one. It's about 500 yards. I'm gonna walk this way a little bit. Let's go take a look at him. There's the first one I got. I'm guessing that's about 500 yards, maybe a little further. Right up there is that wing wall again, that cement wall. That's where I was shooting from. I get back to the truck, I'll show you the gun I'm shooting today. And hopefully this isn't the end of it. So get some more for you before the end of the summer. Here's the gun I'm shooting today. I shot some of those long range groundhogs with. It is a 7mm Remington Magnum. I bought this gun as an ADL. I have since converted it to BDL. Put a Hogue Overmold stock on it. It's like a Dura Touch. Has a much better grip to it when you're shooting. Doesn't seem to want to slide out of the palm of your hand. And 4-12 Leopold scope, Harris bipods. Shot a few deer with it long range. I guess 300-400 yards if you want to call that long range. And plan on doing some more with it. Oh, and getting ready for trapping season. A little logwood trap die, wire screen, little fang earth anchors. It's going to be a good summer. Got some work to do yet for the trap line. And more groundhogs to shoot. Alright, I want to talk to you a little bit today about long range shooting. What I do when I'm hand loading. And what it takes to actually hit what you're aiming for at 500 plus yards. I just recently have shot some groundhogs over 500 yards. Some of which that are on film. I shot one at 640 yards. I did not get on film. I tried to take the camera up the following night and tried to duplicate what I did the night before. Didn't get one at that far, but I got one at what I figured to be around 500 yards and another one what I figured to be about 575. The tools I had to do that, my father has a chronograph, which will tell me how fast in feet per second my bullet is traveling. A lot of times in your hand loading books, when it tells you the load's going for particular grains you put in the casing, it's typically not the same as what's shown in the book. Sometimes differences are like 300 feet per second. So it's important for me to have the chronograph so I know how fast I'm going, at which point I can plug in the information into. I have an app on my phone, it's called Nozzler Ballistic, and it tells me right to 25 yard increments if that's what I want. How much I'm dropping at certain distances. It also can tell me how much wind drift I have, depending on wind velocities and those sorts of things, what degree the wind's blowing at a 90 degree angle or whatnot. Very, very handy to have with. The chronograph's pretty important also. And my father also has a range finder. If you know the range, typically your tables, your ballistic tables, can tell you where you're going to be hitting it at those ranges if you know your velocity and ballistic coefficient. Now with ballistic coefficient, what I'm shooting is my 7mm Remington Magnum. It has a 4-12 Leopold scope on it, and it has a Hogue Overmold stock. It's a full-length aluminum bedding block. Also, I have Harris bipods on it. With this 120-grain ballistic tip that I'm shooting, I'm typically shooting about a half-inch group at 100 yards. It's pretty accurate for me. But ballistic coefficient, basically, now I don't have a Webster's Dictionary definition of what it is, but basically it's how well your bullet travels through the air, how well it fights the resistance of the air. These particular bullets, I believe, are around 0.415 or 0.420. The higher your number, the more ballistically coefficient it is, and the better it will cut air, and the less drop you'll have at longer distances. Also, the wind will affect it less. So the ballistic coefficient plays a big role in shooting long range.
Now I have, like I said, I have some video of that already. I'm gonna hand load about 10 more shells up. I'm hopefully gonna get a couple more for you. Now when you're watching the video, I want you to kind of pay attention to, you'll see the bullet curling to the left or right depending on the wind. And it's pretty neat to see. You can see the bullet cut in the air and you can actually see it curling in into the target. But I only have two long range groundhogs, or what I consider long range, 500 plus yards on film at this time. But summer's young yet. We're gonna try to get a couple more for you. Also, Dad probably gonna be on here some too. He has a 25-06, I believe he's gonna get out. And he also has 220 Swift and other guns as well. What I'm hand loading with, I'm shooting an IMR 4350 powder, and it's pushing my bullet about 3450. I believe the book says it's less than that, but we're getting going a little bit faster. You want to watch your max loads, you don't want to go over them. And there's a bunch of stuff you really need to kind of get into this. I'm fortunate to have my dad that has pretty much all the necessary stuff to really get a really super accurate load for this gun. So enjoy the groundhog video. Like I said, pay attention to that bullet curling in. The wind direction changes in one night. The first three or four shots, it's coming from the right to left. The other part of it's coming left to right, and you can see it in bullet flight. So pay attention to that. Enjoy the video.
Well, there it is. The first groundhog with a flintlock muzzleloader.